Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths tutorial. Mean value theorems, class number 5. In this class, we solve some problems depends upon Rolle's mean value theorem. Let us see the problems. Verify Rolle's theorem for the following functions. F of x is equals to 2 plus x minus 1 whole power 2 by 3 in closed interval 0 comma 2. F of x is equals to e power x sin x in closed interval 0 comma pi. F of x is equals to x into x plus 3 e power minus x by 2 in closed interval minus 3 comma 0. F of x is equals to mod x in closed interval minus 1 comma 1. Let us see one by one. The first one, f of x is equals to 2 plus x minus 1 whole power 2 by 3, where closed interval a comma b is equals to 0 comma 2. It means a is equals to 0, b is equals to 2. What is Rolle's mean value theorem? A function f maps closed interval a comma b into capital R satisfying three conditions. F is continuous in closed interval a comma b, and second condition is f is derivable in open interval a comma b, and third condition is f of a is equals to f of b, then there exists c belongs to open interval a comma b such that f dash of c is equals to 0. A function f maps closed interval a comma b into capital R which satisfies three properties. F is continuous in closed interval a comma b, derivable in open interval a comma f is continuous in closed interval a comma b, f is derivable in open interval a comma b, and f of a is equals to f of b, then there exists a constant, or then there exists a real number c belongs to open interval a comma b such that f dash of c is equals to 0. So let us verify the conditions. It is very clear, constant function and it is a polynomial, so clearly f of x is continuous. On closed interval 0 comma 2. Let us differentiate this function f dash of x. F dash of x means d by dx of f of x. D by dx of what is f of x here? 2 plus x minus 1 whole power 2 by 3. Derivative of constant 0 plus derivative of x minus 1 whole power 2 by 3. 2 by 3 x minus 1 whole power 2 by 3 minus 1. We know that derivative of x power n. Derivative of x power n is equals to n into x power n minus 1. We use that formula here. So you get 2 by 3 x minus 1 power 2 by 3 whole power minus 1 x minus 1 whole power minus 1 by 3. By simplifying that function we get f dash of x is equals to 2 divided by 3 into x minus 1 power 1 by 3. You observe that f dash of x tends to infinity as x tends to 1. This is the important condition here. F dash of x tends to infinity means x tends to 1 means if x is equals to 1, then you get 0 in the denominator. Anything by 0 is equals to infinity. So here f dash of x tends to infinity as x tends to 1. You observe that in between 0 and 1 there must be 1. Therefore f dash of x does not exist at x is equals to 1, which belongs to open interval 0 comma 2, which belongs to open interval 0 comma 2. Let us continue. So if f dash of x does not exist at x is equals to 1 means, therefore f of x is not derivable. F of x is not derivable in the open interval 0 comma 2, which is the second condition of Rolle's theorem. Therefore, f of x does not satisfy Rolle's theorem. F of x does not satisfy Rolle's theorem because of f dash of x does not exist at the point x is equals to 1. Observe that. Let us go for next problem. Second one. f of x is equals to e power x sin x. Problem number 2, f of x is equals to e power x into sin x, and the closed interval a comma b is equals to closed interval 0 comma pi, where a is equals to 0, b is equals to pi. We know that e power x is continuous, e power x is continuous on capital R, and sin x is also continuous on capital R. Again, we know that the product of two continuous functions is continuous. The product of two continuous functions, is continuous. So, e power x is continuous on R, sin x is continuous on R. Both the functions e power x and sin x are continuous on the set of real numbers. They are trivially continuous on. These two functions are continuous on closed interval 0 to pi. So therefore, by using this condition, the product of two continuous functions is continuous. F of x is continuous on closed interval 0, pi. Which is the first property of Rolle's theorem. So let us go for second condition. F dash of x. It is very trivial. D by dx of f of x. Which is equals to d by dx of e power x sin x. Apply the derivative of uv rule. E power x into sin x. Plus e power x into cos x. It is very clear, derivative also exists. Therefore, we conclude that f of x is derivable and open interval 0 to pi. Yes, continue. What is the lower limit here? 0. Now calculate f of 0. F of 0 is equals to e power 0 sin 0. E power 0 1 sin 0 0 0. Verify the value f of pi. E power pi into sin pi. E power pi into 0. Again you get 0. Therefore f of 0 is equals to f of pi. Now you observe that f of x is continuous on closed interval 0 to pi. F of x is derivable on open interval 0 to pi. F of 0 is equals to f of pi. This is the first condition of Rolle's theorem, second condition of Rolle's theorem, third condition of Rolle's theorem. Therefore, f of x satisfies all the three properties of Rolle's mean value theorem. If a function satisfies all the three properties of Rolle's mean value theorem, then there exists a constant C belongs to the open interval 0 to pi such that f dash of C is equals to 0. Here, what is f dash of x? E power x sin x plus e power x cos x. Therefore, f dash of C means e power c sin c plus e power c cos c. By making e power c common, you get sin c plus cos c. By Rolle's theorem, you have f dash of c is equals to 0. If f dash of c is equals to 0, then we have e power c into sin c plus cos c is equals to 0. But you observe that e power c is always not equals to 0. For any value of c, then what is equal to 0? Sin c plus cos c is equals to 0, which implies sin c is equals to minus cos c. which implies tan C is equals to minus 1. Tan C, by dividing on both the sides, it's sin cos C. Tan C is equals to minus 1. It is equals to tan of 3 pi by 4. Tan 3 pi by 4 is equals to minus 1. You verify that. Tan 3 pi by 4 is equals to minus 1. And you observe that this 3 pi by 4 is clearly lies between 0 and pi. So this condition implies us. This condition implies us. C is equals to 3 pi by 4. C is equals to 3 pi by 4, which belongs to the open interval 0 to pi. 0 to pi, which is the required result also. Therefore, there exists C is equals to 3 pi by 4, which belongs to open interval 0 to pi, such that f dash of 3 pi by 4 is equals to 0, where C is equals to 3 pi by 4. This is the required constant of Rolle's mean value theorem. Required constant of Rolle's mean value theorem. You verify that this function is homework for you. It is very clearly satisfies the Rolle's mean value theorem. Clearly, it satisfies Rolle's mean value theorem. You check out, I solve this third problem. Let us go for fourth one. Problem number 4. Here given that, problem number 4. F of x is equals to mod x. And closed interval a comma b is equals to closed interval minus 1 comma 1. Where a is equals to minus 1 and b is equals to 1. It is clear that f of x is equals to mod x is continuous for every x belongs to capital R. It is very clear f of x is equals to mod x is continuous for every x belongs to capital R. Therefore, f of x is continuous on closed interval minus 1 comma 1. It is continuous everywhere. Therefore, it is continuous in the particular interval, closed interval minus 1 comma 1. You have to check the derivability. Check the derivability. At x is equals to, let us check the derivability. It is very clear, 0 belongs to closed interval minus 1 comma 1. We check the derivability at 0. Left hand derivative at x is equals to 0. Left hand derivative at x is equals to 0, which is denoted by L f dash of 0, which is equals to limit x tends to 0 minus f of x minus f of 0 divided by x minus 0, which is equals to limit x tends to 0 minus f of x minus f of 0 is 0. So, you get f of x by x. So, replace x by 0 minus h, which is equals to limit h tends to 0, 0 minus h divided by x is replaced by 0 minus h. Put x is equals to 0 minus h. So, you get finally h cancel, minus minus h cancel, you get 1, f of x by x. Where you observe that f of x is equals to mod x. Put x is equals to 0 minus h. So, which is equals to limit h tends to 0. F of x means mod 0 minus h divided by 0 minus h. You get limit h tends to 0, h by minus h, you get minus 1. L f dash of 0 is equals to minus 1. Let us go for right hand derivative. R right hand derivative at x is equals to 0. R f dash of 0 is equals to limit x tends to 0 plus f of x minus f of 0 divided by x minus 0. Limit x tends to 0 plus f of x divided by x. Again, put x is equals to 0 plus h. if you put x is equals to 0 plus h, this limit becomes limit h tends to 0 f of x mod 0 plus h divided by h, which is equals to 1, which is equals to 1. Now you observe that right hand derivative r f dash of 0 is equals to 1, l f dash of 0 is equals to minus 1. Therefore, we conclude that L f dash of 0, left hand derivative at 0, not equals to right hand derivative at 0. Therefore, f of x is not derivable. F of x is not derivable at x is equals to 0. F of x is not derivable at x is equals to 0. Therefore, what is the second condition for Rolle's theorem? Derivability. So, it not satisfied. Therefore, f of x is not derivable or differentiable at x is equals to 0, which belongs to open interval comma 1. It means f of x is not derivable at 0 means f of x is not derivable in the open interval minus 1 comma 1. Therefore, f of x does not satisfy Rolle's mean value theorem. F of x does not satisfy Rolle's mean value theorem. Practice these four problems and do homework problem number 3. It satisfies all the three properties of Rolle's theorem. And fourth one is very, very important for section A, means for 6 marks question, and important for different competitive exams also. Keep learning. In the next class, we solve some another problems, depends upon the same Rolle's mean value theorem. Keep learning.